another SBS Monday motivation. This is a big one. This is the day before the holiday, the day before Christmas Eve. Tomorrow's Christmas Eve. Of course, Wednesday is the holiday. It's going to be a time where our schedules change. We're around family and loved ones, the gift sharing, the parties, the events. It's going to be a great time. So there's also time for us to fall into those dark areas, those dark recesses of our brain, when we think about who's not around during the holidays, when we think about what we're doing and what we need to be working on and things like that. So I want to talk about counting your wins. You want to count your wins. Now, what do I mean by that? I don't think we should go through a state of always saying, I did it, I did it, I did it. However, I think it's very important that we count our wins. What I mean by that, I can recall over the past few years with the work I've been doing, there's a certain time in the day for me where I start to get down. Yes, that's right. Mr. Positive starts to get down. It's a reality. It will come around 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Because in most cases, I did all of my work throughout the day. I made my calls, shot my emails between like early morning to about like 10 or 11 o'clock. I've kind of did the bulk of what I had to do as far as communicating out. Now, the hard part is by 3 o'clock, you don't hear back from who you may have communicated with earlier, or the thing you started on in the morning may not be moving right along. So I think it's important that you spend the rest of your day counting your wins. Go back and say, Lindsay, you did a great job by reaching out and sending that email. Lindsay, you did a great job by making that phone call. Lindsay, you did a great job by going to that meeting. That way, during that latter part of the day, that 3 p.m., that 5 p.m., that 7 p.m., when you can really get down, at least I would get down because I'm not seeing any movement. It would get me into a negative state. But instead, with the approach of counting my wins throughout the day, it keeps me in a positive state of mind. They said that the brain can function better, even at a higher capacity of even 31% more positively based on being in a positive frame of mind, meaning that if you're in a positive frame of mind, you can be more productive. So again, the idea I have today about counting your wins is no matter what you get accomplished today, if you have that list of things and you check it, when you get to that latter part, that mid part of the day or that day where you're not able to do any more putting things out, go back and count your wins. And that way it's going to put you in a positive state of mind on what you've done compared to saying, oh, my goodness, I didn't hear back from them. Oh, my goodness, I still haven't got a response. Oh, my goodness, that project didn't work. And then you split the idea. You don't want to get into the negative thinking. Because when you get into that negative thinking, it begins to spiral just like a positive mindset can. And I think sometimes it's very easy to be in a negative rut, to be in a negative frame of mind, to kind of sit there and be stuck. But we need that positive thinking to kickstart what we're thinking to go forward. And it's very important during these times, these holiday times, when we reflect, we reminisce, though we're sharing all these great things we have, it's so very easy for us to think about what we don't have, who's not with us, and whatnot. So I think it's very important to do that. So count your wins. You know, be your biggest cheerleader. Keep yourself motivated. There's nothing wrong with staying positive all the time because the reverse is being in a negative state of mind. And this is a very difficult time for a lot of people. This is a time where it's probably very important that you try to be as encouraging as possible to people you know. This is a time we want to limit, if not eliminate completely, the toxicity that comes with what we're dealing with and continue to go from there. So I won't keep you guys too long. This is the holiday version of the Monday Motivation. Tomorrow is Christmas Eve. Then we got the holiday, and then we're looking into the new year. So it'll be a little while before I hear from you. However, you will see me on Friday at Detroit Crystal Race. Shout out to my guy, Brandon Peoples. Shout out to my guy, Jimmy Sanders, the plug. But Brandon Peoples and the Coyotes of Detroit Crystal Way will be hosting the Cleveland Crystal Ray. That's right. There's going to be a interstate matchup in basketball. I'm looking forward to being over there, not just talking about mental toughness, but also mental health. So it should be a really positive time. I really thank you guys for your support. I want to wish you guys the best in this holiday season. You won't hear from me formally until after Christmas. So I want to wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year in advance. But count your wins. You've done a great job. Keep yourself in that positive a perpetual cycle all the time. So with that, I'll sign off. Lindsay Hollison with SBS. We'll be back in the building soon. Thanks for your support.